Yo, what's up, y'all? It's Pop. We back at it again with the film study, with the scoring breakdowns. We're going to take a look at the highest performer from last night, which appears to be Devin Booker. They played the Cleveland Cavaliers. Devin Booker had 36, as well as a victory. We're going to try to do today's video straight through. No edits, no cuts, none of that. So stick with me. Might get a little shaky. Might get a little drawn out. First play here, we got a high screen, snake it, dribble. Oh, good attack. Snakes the pick and roll here. Now, what Chris Paul would do, Chris Paul would, you know, stop right here and put that guy on his back. But Devin Booker isn't Chris Paul, so he just continues to attack for a tough off-balance shot. Look at this, left, right, back to the right hand. That's tough. Off the glass, too. Back cut. Good cut. Great cut. Great cut. You see here the defender's caught. Not, he's man watching. He's not watching the ball. So the ball comes over here. And now he's ball watching. Now he's not watching his man. He's watching the ball. He wants to see where that pass is going to go. So Devin just hits him with a boom. Great cut. Fake to the ball, cut back door. Fake to the ball, cut back door. Great cut. Ooh, that's a great diversion screen. Notice how Devin Booker sets the screen here. And he doesn't use it. He rejects the screen, which takes two defenders away. This is just poor defensive communication. They don't communicate. They don't make it known who's going to switch, who's going to pick up. And he just leaks out for an open three. Transition cross. Good take. Jab, step back over Chetty. This is something that Brad did. This is something that Bradley did in the last breakdown. The last Bradley Bill breakdown that I did. Just catch it up top, face up, jab. Step back. Tough, tough shot. Had he had more time on the shot clock, I'm not sure if he would have taken that shot. But he knocked it down, so. One dribble, pull up three, and one. That's just a great shot by a great player. It's nothing to look at there. If you can't hit that shot, you know, don't take that shot. It don't matter how many times you break something like that down. If you can't hit it, you can't hit it. I mean, that's something that you can learn. I mean, this is just a simple attack step back. Not many players shoot this shot anymore. You're going to attack here. Boom. Step back. Take them full speed. Plant on that outside foot right here. Plant on that outside foot. Take a little step back. Raise up. The key to that one, though, is you want to attack and get right to your spot. This is a great, great play. Down screen, catch, one dribble, pull up. This looks like 2008 Kobe or something. Because nowadays, you get a down screen here and everybody wants to pop out to this three-point line right here so they could try to get a three. But instead, he gets the screen. He curls tight to make sure he's getting the most of that screen. He takes a tight angle right here. Had he came out to the three-point line, the defender might have been able to recover. So it's all, when you get down screens like this, you need to know how much space you have so that you can curl tight off the screen. Curl tight off the screen. Catch this ball right here. One dribble pull-up. Missed it. He got it back. Got it back. Ooh, post up. Post up D-Book. Basic, basic, basic. Basic is good, though. Because if you don't have to expend a lot of energy, don't. You see right here on this one, he has a mismatch. I don't know who this kid is in the paint, but it's a mismatch. And all he needed was this one bump right here. Boom. Right into his chest. Boom. Soon as he did that, he bounced back. That's all the space you need. That's all the space you need. This is a 5-foot jumper, if that. You get enough space just to get your shot up, just knock it down. Post. Yeah, he's just small, man. He's just small. People forget Devin Booker's 6'6". Legit 6'6". So I'm just going right up. Right up. And being as though he is 6'6", you know, a lot of two guards in the league are about 6'3", 6'4". They're not like how they used to be, like in Kobe's era, where two guards were 6'6" and up. If Devin Booker could get down in the paint more and add that to his game, he'd be unstoppable. Because he's already 6'6". Kobe was 6'6". Jordan was 6'6". So there's no excuse to not be able to implement some of their game into your game. You know what I mean? What the hell? He's shooting off the hip like Texas Lone Ranger. Here. Dribble. Look at the ball. The ball is literally on the hip. On the hip. On the hip. On the hip. Raise up. Meow. Looking like Tonto. Here we get a screen. Once again, take him down into that post. There we go. There we go. There we go. You don't got to do a lot. You don't got to do a lot. Get the screen. Get comfortable in that post. Boom. Switch hands. And now you're right here in your spot. Dribble, put that shoulder into him, turn around. That's the shot. That's the Kobe to Jordan shot. That if he can hit those, you know, he'd be unstoppable. If you look at his shot chart over here, you can see he did a lot down here in this paint. He's took his threes, you know, he's still a great three-point shooter. But a lot of them is right here in his paint. That's because of the matchups on Cleveland side. The matchups on Cleveland side, they don't have a lot of tall guards. You know, Colin Sexton is only, what, 6'2"? So, Devin Booker gets a mismatch. He just takes him down here in his paint and goes to work. Bully ball. And that's what I love to see. I wish we had more two guards in the league that played that way. You know, nowadays, all the two guards just want to stand around and do step back threes like James Harden. But you get a 6'6 two guard with strength. Take him down here in his post. Get to your spot and get your easy buckets. You know, until next time, like, comment, subscribe, add me on Instagram, Pushing Our Potential, DT973, and we out. See the shots that I took, wet like I'm Book, wet like I'm Lizzy. I mean, spinning rain so much till I'm dizzy, yeah. Like we're Lizzy, yeah. No one's seen them, trying to clean them, yeah.